Well, how's it going today there, YouTube? We're down here at one of these here side jobs I got going on. I'm working on that Cadillac again. I mean, look, you can tell. Cadillac. That's the same car I was telling you guys about earlier. I did the brakes and the wheel bearings on, and now I'm doing a little bit of body work. And you might not actually believe me when I tell you this, but I'll put a picture on there if I haven't already deleted it off my phone. I actually sprayed the holes in this car full of spray foam, the same kind of stuff you squirt in your house windows. So actually, it worked not too bad. I just got the first coat of Bondo put on. I'll flip this phone around here and you guys can have a little look. Well, if you guys have ever wondered if a drywaller can do Bondo, yes, absolutely you can. See, that's the one fender. A little spot there. A little spot in the door down there we're kind of working on. That one didn't feather out so nice, but I gotta sand it. You can see some of the spray foam, but you know, skim it out and you'll be alright. Hopefully the color matches up here. It is almost a 20-year-old car. And then you got this fender going too. So now we'll see how she sands out. Anyway, we'll keep your eyes posted. Okay, so we're back at this Caddy again. This is day two now of this vlog. And I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I kind of fucked up the first time I put that first coat of Bondo on the car. I got frustrated with the first time. Didn't have my ratio right for my hardener and Bondo. I didn't put any hardener in it the first time. So didn't exactly dry out like I hoped it would, but it's not bad now. I got it skimmed out now. You guys can see that. I hope you can see that. It's not bad. I got it feathered out now, so should come out alright. Let's get some paint on it. The paint actually doesn't match. Not too bad, but I mean, it's 16-year-old paint versus brand new Cape of paint. So what do you expect? Besides, this is just a kind of help a buddy out kind of job, so. Eh, it doesn't look too bad. It'll look alright when it's done, so we'll keep working here and keep you guys posted. There's the driver's quarter. This part here, you can tell it on video probably because I already filled the primer and I put one coat of color on it. And you know, it's not too bad. You can see a little right there. That's because the primer's thrown with the paint. I've only got one color. I'm going to end up bunning that and that together. You'll probably never even see it. So, like I said, I'm just some dumb redneck looking for some extra money, so. The only reason why I'm doing this, same as doing drywall, but this is not bad. It's almost ready for sanding, final sand and paint. I'm gonna sand it with some, I've got some 400 grit and I got some 320 grit too, so might be alright. We'll see how it goes. Okay, well, I got the last sand and primed it, and I got the first coat of color. Not too bad. You can just see a little ridge where I didn't really feather it out too great. Run out of sandpaper. I went through a lot of sandpaper this morning. It's starting to get darker too, you know. That side's not too bad though, but I still gotta spray this door down. I gotta feather it a little bit better yet. So, this trim piece goes on there anyway, so I'll feather the door as best I can, and then I'll just shoot what goes underneath the trim, and then that way, you know, we can say job complete. And we're laughing. Yeah, not too bad, not too bad. Better than rotten spray foam anyway.